Hi, boys and girls. Happy Tuesday. It's Mrs. Owen, Miss Layla, and Word Monster. We have a couple quick shout-outs we're going to do. First up, we have our happy numbers. So all these friends are going to get a high five for their hard work. We have Selwyn, Cecilia, Emerson, Kennedy, Tyson, Luke, Madeline, Aiden, Sawyer, and Kenzie. Good job. And hold on, wait a minute. Two really hard workers. We have, lots and lots of points. We have Jessica. Oh, drum roll. We have Jessica, double high five. And another drum roll, Layla. Drum roll. Sebastian, good job to those two friends. And for RAS Kids, we have high fives to these friends. Sawyer, Madeline, Luke, Kennedy, Aiden, and hold on. Our top star friends are double high five. I need a drum roll. We have Selwyn with our top stars and Sebastian again. Good job. Good job, friends. Keep up the good work. And to all my other friends, too, we're really proud of you. All right, Mr. Word Monster, we're going to put you over there. I'm going to read one of my favorite stories to you today. It's called Muncha, Muncha, Muncha. And Miss Layla is going to help me with some of the words in the book today. Our author is Candace Fleming, and the illustrator is G. Brian Karras. All right, Muncha, Muncha, Muncha. For years, Mr. McGreeley dreamed of planting a garden. He dreamed of getting his hands dirty, of growing yummy vegetables, and of gobbling them all up. Maybe you guys have seen some other people, or maybe at your house, planting gardens outside right now. But he never once tried it until this spring, said Mr. McGreeley. This spring, by golly, I'm going to plant a garden. So he thought about it for years and years. So he hoed and he sowed, and he watched his garden grow. Lettuce, carrots, peas, tomatoes. Yum, yum, yummy, said Mr. McGreeley. I'll soon fill my tummy with crisp, fresh veggies. Yummy. But one night, when the sun went down and the moon came up, three hungry bunnies appeared. Tippy, 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 pat. Muncha, muncha, muncha. Do you think Mr. McGreeley's going to be happy?
No. Maybe he made it for the rabbits.
Maybe. Let's see. The next morning, when Mr. McGreeley saw his gnawed sprouts, he was angry. So he built a small wire fence all around his vegetable garden. There, he declared, no bunny can get into my garden now.
No, they can dig. Rabbits can dig holes.
You think so? Yeah. Let's see if it works. As the sun went down and the moon came up, and tippy, 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 pat. Spring hurdle, dash, dash, dash. What did the bunny say? Muncha, muncha, muncha. I know if my friends were in the classroom, they'd help me say it too, wouldn't they? Oh, you want to see the pages? The next morning, when Mr. McGreeley saw his nibbled leaves and his gnawed sprouts, he was really angry. So he built a tall wooden wall behind the small wire fence all around his vegetable garden. He huffed, those floppy ears will never get over it. No bunny can get into my garden now. Wow, look at that. Do you think there's any possible way they can get through that? What do you think, Layla?
Well, maybe they can still dig.
It's a good prediction. Let's turn the page.
Because some rabbits live in holes.
Yeah.
So how else would
they dig? Let's find out. As the sun went down and the moon came up, and tippy, 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 pat, dig, scramble, scratch, 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 spring, hurdle, dash, 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 muncha, muncha, muncha. They got through. Oh my goodness, friends, look at his face. Layla, can you describe his face right now? How is our character feeling in this story?
He's probably very annoyed because he's tried his best to keep on getting them away from his garden, but it doesn't work, and he used all his work to do. But so he's so angry.
The next morning, when Mr. McGreeley saw his chewed stems, his nibbled leaves, and his gnawed sprouts, he was really, really angry. So he made a deep, wet trench outside the tall wooden wall behind the small wire fence all around his vegetable garden. Ha, he snorted, those pufftails can't get under it, they can't get over it. No bunny can get into my garden now. Wow, look at that. He's not messing around, is he?
Maybe they can hop over it.
Maybe.
They have hopping powers that goes.
Do you guys see the little bunny ears over there? They're watching. Let's see what happens. As the sun went down and the moon came up and tippy, tippy. Pat.
Wait, but how will he be able
dive, to paddle, splash, 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 dig, scramble, scratch, 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 spring, hurdle, dash, 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 muncha, muncha, muncha. Oh, they found a way in. Oh my goodness. Look at that.
Oh,
like he built a castle. The next morning, when Mr. McGreeley saw his chomped blossoms, his chewed stems, his nibbled leaves, and his gnawed sprouts, he was furious in big, big, bold words, letters. So he hammered and blocked, sawed and stacked, drilled and filled, and trapped and locked, and he built a huge, enormous thing before the deep, wet trench outside the tall wooden wall behind the small wire fence all around his vegetable garden. I've outsmarted those twitch whiskers for sure, he exclaimed. They can't get through it, they can't get under it, and they can't get over it. No bunny, no way, no how can get into my vegetable garden now. What do you think, friends? Is there any way those bunnies can get past this? Layla, what do you think? Yes or no?
Well, I see a ladder, so maybe that's...
Well, for sure he'll take that ladder away.
Well, how... is he supposed to even get back into the garden? That
right?
How does he fix it? Maybe they've been watching and saw how he gets in.
There's their ears. All right, let's turn. Let's find out. And the sun went down, and the moon came up, and tippy, 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 stop. The three hungry bunnies looked and smelled and touched the huge, enormous thing before them. And tippy, tippy pat. The bunnies hopped away. I'm intrigued. I must turn the page and find out. The next morning, when Mr. McGreeley saw his untouched vegetables, he was, what is that word? Happy. Look at his face. Has he outsmarted them?
Did he think I was another garden?
I beat the bunnies. He whooped. And he did a jiggly wiggly victory dance. And he climbed over, jumped across, squeezed between, and crawled under until he reached his vegetable garden. Ah, sighed Mr. McGreeley at last, smacking his lips. He picked and pulled up lettuce, carrots, peas, tomatoes, and with his basket overflowing, look at that big basket, do you guys see that? Wow. He reached inside for something yummy. Look at all that. Are you guys seeing that? Layla, do you see the basket?
Oh, that's huge.
Yes.
Oh my
goodness.
I could like fit in that.
Oh, do you see something in the basket that looks a little suspicious though?
Those.
What are those?
They look like bunny ears.
Can you help me read the last page? Muncha. Did he outsmart the bunnies, or did they outsmart him?
They outsmarted him.
Mm-hmm. And here's the last page. There are no words. I think he finally gave up.
Yeah.
The
and Jess was
end.
Like, let's just share.
I hope you enjoyed our story today. And friends, you have a happy spring break and a happy Easter. Mm-hmm. We will see you next week. Bye-bye. Love you.
Have a nice day.